A Microwriter MW4, a keyset or chorded keyboard, is a computer input device that allows the user to enter characters or commands formed by pressing several keys together. Like playing a chord on a piano. The large number of combinations available from a small number of keys allows text or commands to be entered with one hand, leaving the other hand free. A secondary advantage is that it can be built into a device that is too small to contain a normal-sized keyboard. A chorded keyboard minus the board, typically designed to be used while held in the hand, is called a keyer. Douglas Engelbart introduced the chorded keyset as a computer interface in 1968 at what is often called the mother of all demos. An ergonomic chorded keyboard without the board is known as a keyer. Each key is mapped to a number and then can be mapped to a corresponding letter or command. By pressing two or more keys together, the user can generate many combinations. In Engelbart's original mapping, he used five keys, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. The keys were mapped as follows: A equals 1, B equals 2, C equals 3, D equals 4, and so on. If the user pressed keys 1 plus 2 equals 3 simultaneously, and then released the keys, the letter C appeared. Unlike pressing a chord on a piano, the chord is recognized only after all the keys or mouse buttons are released. Since Engelbart introduced the keyset, several different designs have been developed based on similar concepts. As a crude example, each finger might control one key which corresponds to one bit in a byte, so that using seven keys and seven fingers, one could enter any character in the ASCII set, if the user could remember the binary codes. Due to the small number of keys required, chording is easily adapted from a desktop to mobile environment. Practical devices generally use simpler chords for common characters, or may have ways to make it easier to remember the chords, but the same principles apply. These portable devices first became popular with the wearable computer movement in the 1980s. Thad Starner from Georgia Institute of Technology and others published numerous studies showing that two-handed chorded text entry was faster and yielded fewer errors than on a QWERTY keyboard. Currently, Stenotype machines hold the record for fastest word entry. Many Stenotype users can reach 300 words per minute. However, stenographers typically train for 3 years before reaching professional levels of speed and accuracy. The earliest known chord keyboard was part of the five-needle telegraph operator station, designed by Wheatstone and Cook in 1836, in which any two of the five needles could point left or right to indicate letters on a grid. It was designed to be used by untrained operators, and was not used where trained telegraph operators were available. The first widespread use of a chord keyboard was in the stenotype machine used by court reporters, which was invented in 1868 and is still in use. The output of the stenotype was originally a phonetic code that had to be transcribed later, rather than arbitrary text. Automatic conversion software is now commonplace. In 1874, the 5-bit BODO telegraph code and a matching 5-key chord keyboard was designed to be used with the operator forming the codes manually. The code is optimized for speed and low wear. Chords were chosen so that the most common characters use the simplest chords. But telegraph operators were already using typewriters with QWERTY keyboards to copy received messages, and at the time it made more sense to build a typewriter that could generate the codes automatically, rather than making them learn to use a new input device. IBM 026 commercial card codes. Some early key punch machines used a keyboard with 12 labeled keys to punch the correct holes in paper cards. The numbers 0 through 9 were represented by one punch, 26 letters were represented by combinations of two punches, and symbols were represented by combinations of two or three punches. A Braille keyboard. Braille uses either 6 or 8 tactile points from which all letters and numbers are formed. When Louis Braille invented it, it was produced with a needle holding successively all needed points in a cardboard sheet. In 1892, Frank Haven Hall, superintendent of the Illinois Institute for the Education of the Blind, created the Hall Braille Writer, which was like a typewriter with 6 keys, one for each dot in a Braille cell. The Perkins Brailler, first manufactured in 1951, uses a 6-key chord keyboard to produce Braille output, and has been very successful as a mass-market affordable product. Braille, like BODO, uses a number symbol and a shift symbol, which may be repeated for shift lock, to fit numbers and uppercase into the 63 codes that 6 bits offer. After World War II, with the arrival of electronics for reading chords and looking in tables of codes, the postal sorting offices started to research chordic solutions to be able to employ people other than trained and expensive typists. In 1954, an important concept was discovered: Chordic production is easier to master when the production is done at the release of the keys instead of when they are pressed. Researchers at IBM investigated chord keyboards for both typewriters and computer data entry as early as 1959, with the idea that it might be faster than touch typing if some chords were used to enter whole words or parts of words. A 1975 design by IBM fellow Nat Rochester had 14 keys that were dimpled on the edges as well as the top, so one finger could press two adjacent keys for additional combinations. Their results were inconclusive, but research continued until at least 1978. Doug Engelbart began experimenting with keysets to use with the mouse in the mid-1960s. In a famous 1968 demonstration, Engelbart introduced a computer-human interface that included the QWERTY keyboard, a three-button mouse, and a five-key keyset. Engelbart used the keyset with his left hand and the mouse with his right to type text and enter commands. The mouse buttons marked selections and confirmed or aborted commands. Users in Engelbart's Augmentation Research Center at SRI became proficient with the mouse and keyset. In the 1970s, the funding Engelbart's group received from the Advanced Research Projects Agency was cut, and many key members of Engelbart's team went to work for Xerox PARC, where they continued to experiment with the mouse and keyset. Keycord sets were used at Xerox PARC in the early 1980s, along with mice, GUIs, on the Xerox Star and Alta workstations. A one-button version of the mouse was incorporated into the Apple Macintosh, but Steve Jobs decided against incorporating the corded keyset. Xerox Alto keyset, CA. 1973. In the early 1980s, Philips Research Labs at Redhill, Surrey did a brief study into small, cheap keyboards for entering text on a telephone. One solution used a grid of hexagonal keys with symbols inscribed into dimples in the keys that were either in the center of a key, across the boundary of two keys, or at the joining of three keys. Pressing down on one of the dimples would cause either one, two, or three of the hexagonal buttons to be depressed at the same time, forming a chord that would be unique to that symbol. With this arrangement, a nine-button keyboard with three rows of three hexagonal buttons could be fitted onto a telephone and could produce up to 33 different symbols. By choosing widely separated keys, one could employ one dimple as a shift key to allow both letters and numbers to be produced. With 11 keys in a 3/4/4 arrangement, 43 symbols could be arranged, allowing for lowercase text, numbers, and a modest number of punctuation symbols to be represented, along with a shift function for accessing uppercase letters. While this had the advantage of being usable by untrained users via hunt and peck typing and requiring one less key switch than a conventional 12-button keypad, it had the disadvantage that some symbols required three times as much force to depress them as others, which made it hard to achieve any speed with the device. That solution is still alive and proposed by FastApp and Unitap, among others, and a commercial phone has been produced and promoted in Canada during 2006. Historically, the Badeau and Braille keyboards were standardized to some extent, but they are unable to replicate the full character set of a modern keyboard. Braille comes closest, as it has been extended to 8 bits. The only proposed modern standard, COS, can support most characters and functions found on a computer keyboard but has had little commercial development. There is, however, a COS keyboard application available for iPhone since May 8, 2010, for Android since October 3, 2010, and for Mego Harmaton since October 27, 2011. A 104-key USB keyboard adapted into a chording keyboard. All phonetic keystrokes may be accomplished by one and two key chords of the home keys on the top row. Four open-source keyer/keyset designs are available: the PIKI, a PS/2 device based on the PIC microcontroller; the SpiffQuarter, a USB device based on the Atmel AVR family of microcontrollers; the FeatherQuarter, a BLE quarter based on the Adafruit Feather; an all-in-one board incorporating an Arduino-compatible microcontroller; and the GOES keypad driver for Linux, as well as the GOES library for the Atmel/Arduino open-source board. Plover is a free, open-source, cross-platform program intended to bring real-time stenographic technology not just to stenographers, but also to hobbyists using anything from professional stenotype machines to low-cost NKRO gaming keyboards. It is available for Linux, Microsoft Windows, and Apple Mac Mac OS. Joy 2 Chord is a corded keyboard driver for Linux. With a configuration file, any joystick or gamepad can be turned into a corded keyboard. This design philosophy was decided on to lower the cost of building devices, and in turn lower the entry barrier to becoming familiar with corded keyboards. Macro keys and multiple modes are also easily implemented with a user space driver. One minimal chorded keyboard example is Edgar Matias' half-QWERTY keyboard described in patent US 5288158 circa 1992 that produces the letters of the missing half when the user simultaneously presses the spacebar along with the mirror key. Energy 93 published a study by Matias, McKenzie and Buxton showing that people who have already learned to touch type can quickly recover 50-70% of their two-handed typing speed. The loss contributes to the speed discussion above. It is implemented on two popular mobile phones, each provided with software disambiguation, which allows users to avoid using the spacebar. Multiambic keyers for use with wearable computers were invented in Canada in the 1970s. Multiambic keyers are similar to chording keyboards but without the board, in that the keys are grouped in a cluster for being handheld, rather than for sitting on a flat surface. Chording keyboards are also used as portable but two-handed input devices for the visually impaired. Such keyboards use a minimum of 7 keys, where each key corresponds to an individual braille point, except one key which is used as a spacebar. In some applications, the spacebar is used to produce additional chords which enable the user to issue editing commands, such as moving the cursor, or deleting words. Note that the number of points used in braille computing is not 6, but 8, as this allows the user, among other things, to distinguish between small and capital letters, as well as identify the position of the cursor. As a result, most newer chorded keyboards for braille input include at least 9 keys. Touchscreen chorded keyboards are available to smartphone users as an optional way of entering text. As the number of keys is low, the button areas can be made bigger and easier to hit on the small screen. The most common letters do not necessarily require chording, as is the case with the GOES keyboard optimized layouts, where the 12 most frequent characters only require single keys. The Right-Hander, a 12-key chord keyboard from Nuo Company, appeared in 1978 issues of ROM magazine, an early microcomputer applications magazine. Another early commercial model was the 6-button Microwriter, designed by Cy Enfield and Chris Rainey, and first sold in 1980. Microwriting is the system of chord keying and is based on a set of mnemonics. It was designed only for right-handed use. In 1982, the Octima 8-keys chord keyboard was presented by Ergoplik Keyboards Limited, an Israeli startup that was founded by Israeli researcher with intensive experience in man-machine interface design. The keyboard had 8 keys, one for each finger, and additional 3 keys that enabled the production of numbers, punctuations, and control functions. The keyboard was fully compatible with the IBM PC and had keyboards and had an Apple II version as well. Its key combinations were based on a mnemonic system that enabled fast and easy touch type learning. Within a few hours, the user could achieve a typing speed similar to handwriting speed. The unique design also gave a relief from hand stress and allowed longer typing sessions than traditional keyboards. It was multilingual, supporting English, German, French, and Hebrew. The BAD is a 7-key hand-sized device from Infogrip, and has been sold since 1985. It provides 1 key for each finger and 3 for the thumb. It is proposed for the hand which does not hold the mouse, in an exact continuation of Engelbart's vision. Modern examples of chorded keyboards include the Frog Pad, the Intended Method, the Ecopad, Text Faster, and Hot Typer. Some of them are intended for tiny tablet computers and wireless mobile terminals. Many of them are additionally available as apps on Apple's iOS devices. See also the on-screen virtual keyset at Teague Labs. PsyKey Chris Rainey, the co-inventor of Microwriter, reintroduced microwriting for PC and Palm PDAs with a standalone miniature chording keyboard called PsyKey, which caters to both left and right-handed users with 9 keys. PsyKey is named after the Microwriter chord system's co-inventor Cy Enfield. The name also reflects its intuitive nature. CWriter. The CWriter is an app for the iPad and iPhone which uses a close variant of the Microwriter chording system developed by Cy Enfield. It is available via the Apple App Store. This system does not have haptic feedback, hence users cannot tell if their fingers are in the right place without looking. The finger pad positions are adjustable to fit a user's hand size. It also works for left-handed users and has a live speech output facility, useful for individuals with speech impairments. FrogPad. The FrogPad is a 20-key chorded keyboard similar in size to a numeric keypad that can be used with one hand, optimized by character frequency. 85% of average keystrokes in English text can be typed without chording, and chords are limited to 2 fingers. Dekix. The Dekix keyboard uses the IN10-10 key chording method, and is currently on Amazon. It is a wireless one-handed chord keyboard that places 2 keys under each finger in order to utilize one hand for typing. Typically only two fingers are needed for any operations. Each key is essentially a shift key, so that with 10 keys, there are 10 single keystrokes and dozens of 2 and 3 key combinations. The alphabet is produced with a single press for 10 letters or by shifting with either thumb for 16 more. Changing modes, such as number lock, can make other inputs such as numbers, provided with a single keystroke. This avoids complex chords while providing enough keystrokes for efficient typing and allows for some unique implementations such as typing with gloves or on a steering wheel. A video game controller called the X-Skin, using this system, was expected to be commercially available by 2010 to help make morphs popular on console systems and ease entry of common data such as a username and password. But the USB device was never made commercially available. The IN10DID chording system can be applied in single-hand configurations, two-handed or with one key at a time if desired. Claimed advantages of the IN10DID method are the diversity of devices, limited motion and simple chords. Twiddler. The Twiddler is a fully featured 16-key keyboard designed to fit in the palm of one hand. It was originally introduced in the early 1990s by Handike and is currently being produced by Tech Gear. It is popular among wearable computer researchers and hobbyists due to its ease of use, large community of users, and active support by the manufacturer. Every single and multi-key chord on the Twiddler can be customized by the end user.
The Twiddler comes standard with an A, B, C, D chord set, with tab space and other chord sets available.
Chords are not limited to single keystrokes. Multiple keystrokes can be sent with a single chord press. An example of this is an email address or address block can be typed by pressing just one chord. The efficiency gained by using multi-character chords have novice Twiddler users typing at 47 WPM while experts can burst up to 130 WPM. A set NIUP is a virtual keyboard based on chords that appeared in 2012. The alphabet uses the 8 keys of the home row as Aset and NIUP, plus 18 chorded combinations. The layout also makes a less cluttered 10-button keypad for tablet computers, touchscreens, touchpads, and can be used in wired gloves. Thanks for watching.